Hey guys, what's up? Today I decided that I would show you guys me piercing my Medusa piercing. Now, I actually did pierce it like probably a year ago, but I did pierce it in the wrong spot. So I ended up taking it out and I didn't really like it that much, so I took it out. So anyways, I've been doing research and, you know, I've been wanting it for a while. I've been really wanting that piercing to be my last piercing for a couple of years. Who knows, maybe I'll get more. But I did want to do my Medusa piercing, but I wanted to show you guys. I realized that a lot of you guys actually liked my piercing video. I realized that a lot of you guys actually enjoyed me piercing myself, but this is actual a piercing that I want as, you know, my own person. So anyways, I started off by brushing my teeth, and I did also use some mouthwash just to rinse and give a nice clean on the inside of my mouth. So that was the first thing that I did. I also did wash my hands, so yeah. And I do have a couple sets of gloves here so that I am prepared, so that no dirty hands will be involved. And I just want to put out there that in no way, shape, or form am I any type of piercer. I do not own a license. This is just me piercing myself. I do like to buy the kits and stuff online and do my own piercings. It's also just saves time, and a lot of places down here where I am and are closed, and I do want to get a piercing without having to go through all the extras. And since I already have like experience doing my own piercings, then I do want to do it myself, and I just feel better that way, just doing things myself. I don't know, I'm a DIYer, so yay. So I'm just putting on like gloves. So I did find some jewelry. It is suggested to use longer jewelry for the healing process. So I have like three different kinds of jewelry here. I have two long ones that are like really long. My hand behind so you could see. But that is what that looks like. It's like really long. I have one that's a little bit shorter, like a tad bit shorter. Another one that's quite similar to the first one that I showed you guys. So I'm probably gonna most likely go for the longer ones, just because I do want there to be room for healing. So what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna use some of this rubbing alcohol, and I'm gonna pour it inside this cup. This is just an old toy cup here that nobody uses. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put some rubbing alcohol in there just to make sure that these are disinfected and clean. You never wanna put dirty jewelry in for a fresh piercing. So yeah, I'm gonna put this alcohol aside to clean the surface. Just gonna go ahead and finish putting on these gloves real quick. So I also do have some clamps here, and the needles that I'm gonna be using. So I might go for the 16 gauge or I might go for the 14 gauge. Either or is fine. I'm gonna measure and see which one matches. Like, I have extras, so I'll probably use like the extra 14 gauge to measure with the jewelry, just to make sure it fits. You want to make sure it's easy to slide through when you're after you pierce, so that, you know, you can avoid it not fitting and then having to redo it again. That is just definitely nothing you want to do. So I have a bunch of 16 gauge and I have two 14 gauge. So I also have here some, what are these called again, like some clamps. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to clean these and let these also soak in some alcohol for a little while. So this is what they look like. I have a 14 and a 16 gauge. And they're all encased in special packaging, which means it's sterile in the packaging, but once you open it, it is not sterile. So this is why I'm using the extras, just to make sure the jewelry is a perfect fit. So I'm gonna go ahead and take one of these out. So I'm gonna go for this long one. I'm not gonna put my hand on it. I'm actually gonna use a glove. So now I'm gonna take the ball off. Like I said, I'm not going to put my hand on it because this might be the jewelry I'm gonna use. So go ahead, take that ball off, just like so. Okay, so I'm just going to use this end here. And this is the sharp side. So I'm gonna be piercing this way. So I'm gonna wanna make sure that the jewelry fits up this. So I'm gonna go ahead and test it out right now. Again, not gonna use my hand to pick up the jewelry and just checking if it fits. So it does not fit, so I might have to go with the 14 gauge. So it looks like it should fit in here. Yeah. So the 14 gauge is a perfect size for this jewelry. So I'm gonna go in with the 14 gauge, take this out, and I'm gonna put this jewelry back inside. I do have the ball out, but I'm gonna go ahead and keep it out and just put it like on this glove here. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and clean the surface of my mouth. I do have two mirrors here so that I can see exactly where I want my piercing to be. So I'm actually gonna start by using a paper towel just to put my septum inside my nose so it's easier. Now I'm gonna take a different paper towel. Cleaning this, guys. Like I said, you gotta be clean for this. I'm gonna take some rubbing alcohol and I'm gonna clean that front part of my lip. And I'm just gonna look at myself while I do that. The alcohol smells nasty. It stinks. Is it clean? Yuck. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to be using this eyeliner pen here just to mark where I want the hole to be, and just to give myself a guide of what I want. I'm actually gonna wipe it on this paper towel with the rub and alcohol so that it's nice and pointed and ready to go. Talk about doing this yourself as you can check and see what you want as many times as you want. Does that look like it's in the middle? So I'm just gonna actually just go look in my washroom just to be exactly sure. Okay guys, so I just kind of like marked in the middle and then dragged the line down just to make sure it was in the middle. So I think I found the perfect spot where I want it to be. So I'm gonna keep it where it is. So now I'm gonna go ahead and get these clamps, and they are clean and ready to go. So I'm actually gonna look in my mirror real quickly. And yeah, get it right there straight. And lock it on the first one, just like that. Okay, so that's that. I look silly, guys. This is gonna be a painful one. From what I've learned, it's gonna be painful. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up this needle. Once it's open, it is no longer sanitary. So we have got to move fast. And the key is you want to move fast. I look so silly when I'm talking with this on. So let's do it. All right, the needle is open. Okay. Needle is out. I'm ready to go. So I'll be looking in my mirror, you guys. Just in case y'all are wondering what I'm looking at. Okay. So let's do it. This guy's a little over so I can see what I'm doing. Okay guys, so I'm in my washroom. So I'm just gonna do this in here. it'll be a little bit easier for me. Let me check, guys. So I'm looking in my mirror. My face. Let's try and keep going. Should be there soon. So I felt it go through. I just had to finish pushing. Part is almost over. Whew. Guys, my eyes are so red and my face is so sweaty. Oh, son of a bitch. I didn't swear. I didn't. No swearing. Also, I feel that like sharpness, so I'm gonna have to push it. Do you see it? Yep, yeah, so. Slowly let go. Wait. You guys, that's how my face looks. That was pain. Okay, so I'm gonna go wipe around and put the jewelry in. So it's gonna go. It looks so hilarious. My lip feels so sore, guys. Like, ugh, that was actually the hardest piercing ever. I never imagined that I'd get it or do it at all. I was so worried. I was scared how it would feel because, from what I heard, it's the worst mouth piercing ever. It's the hardest one, the most painful one. Let's just clean out here. Alright, so now it's time to put the jewelry. I'm gonna push it down. Ooh, I don't know. That'd be crazy. I think that's long enough yet. The needle. Nasty. So I'm just gonna kind of like grab my hand and like push and put the ball on. Just make sure my hands are dry. Make sure you can grip that ball. And it's bleeding. So here's the ball. Okay, so I'm just looking. That's how it looks. I use a little bit of the rubbing alcohol and some water just to clean it a little. So here it is, the Medusa piercing. Right in the middle. And probably push it down a little. But here it is. It's pretty much a small ball. But now I'm just gonna let it heal. I think it will probably take about 3 to 4 weeks to fully heal. So yeah. I will give you guys like updates. Let me know down below if you guys want to see some updates. Right now, my mouth is super sore, but I like it. It's in the middle this time around. It is swollen. and I used a long enough bar. So yeah, for healing. And obviously when it's done healing, I'll definitely switch it around. But for now, I'm just gonna leave it to heal. Let it do its thing as a piercing should. But tell me what you guys think. Do you like it? Okay, I'll push it down a little. There. What do you think?
I like it.
So I'll see you guys in another video. Let me know if you guys like seeing my piercing videos. I'll definitely drop down below the link where I got all my piercing kits from. I'll even link down BodyJ4You. It is a nice website to check out if you are looking for, you know, piercing equipment or you're just looking for jewelry. You'll definitely be able to find something. There's something for everyone. So check it out if you haven't. I'll definitely drop that down below. Check out my last piercing video if you haven't already seen that I'm the piercing queen. So I'll see you guys in the next one. I don't know what you guys think about my new piercing. I actually really like it. I'm just looking forward for it to heal. And I'm just glad it has a lot of room. So yeah. So anyways, I'll see you guys in another video. Thanks again for watching and bye.